See, y'all underestimate the white man, overestimate the white man, and underestimate your own self. That's why you kill up each other, because y'all think he too powerful to contend with. And y'all think Jesus coming out the sky and gonna save y'all. You know, I think he would have been did it by now. The only Jesus that came over here to save us was Master Farad Muhammad. He did it with the word and the knowledge of self. He tried to give us the knowledge of the enemy, the knowledge of self, and who God is. And he did it. But half of y'all ignoring it. So, you might have to suffer the consequences if you don't hurry up and wake up. But the thing about it is, your future, your children, are going to be exposed to the big bad wolf. Who's afraid of the big bad wolf? Well, three little pigs, you know, they, some of them built a house of stone, some of them built a house of straw, some of them built a house of sticks. And when the wolf came at the door, they said, "Who's afraid of the big bad wolf?" And the wolf said, "You better open this door up or I'll huff and puff and blow the house down." So the only house that he couldn't blow down was the brick house. He blew down the house made of straw. He blew down the house made of wood. But he couldn't blow down that brick house. Remember the Commodores made that song, "She's a Brick House, Mighty Mighty"? Well, that means it's solid, man. Bunch of bricks, you know, put together with mortar and built correctly, you know, it can stand any kind of pressure or wind. But see, we not together. We not together, brothers. And that's one thing that Caucasian got, is unity. That's the difference between us and the Caucasian, the Caucasoid. Don't think he ain't no fighter. But see, now he don't want to kill us all off, though. He just want to weaken our numbers and then make slaves. Well, we already slaves, but he just want to put us in FEMA camps. And when he get ready for us to do work, we do it. He ain't got to pay nobody. In other words, we're going to be like the cats in jail, but the whole America is going to be a jailhouse, you know? And we're going to have to go back to building up the plantation, you know? But now, the reason why it's a perfect time to come in unity with each other is because they don't expect us to. They don't expect y'all to listen to what I'm saying. You know. And if you follow my videos, I'm telling you how to do it. You know. You gotta take back your blocks. Control your blocks. Remember the warriors, that dude Cyrus, what he was saying, it makes sense. But it showed that, you know, they killed him, right, Cyrus. And when they heard that gunshot, they scattered like roaches hitting the light. You know, they'll kill up each other. But when that police, when the police came, it looked like about four or five carloads of police. And it was thousands and thousands, thousands of gangs. They ran from about four or five carloads of police, man. Because really, y'all, you know, black, y'all scared. Because y'all don't have no, the reason why y'all scared because y'all don't have no strategy to control your households, y'all neighborhoods, just in case the Caucasoid decides to just punk, come in and just totally punctify the black and the brown, the red and the yellow. They already got the red on the reservation. They already got the black jacked up. The brown, they're a little bit more stronger. And the yellow is a whole lot more stronger. But we're not unified. So I'm appealing to y'all brothers with ears and with they doped out, drugged out, to come together. Now, another thing, the white man is different from that. That's, you know, he well, I done ran out of time. You know, let me think about this one, the way I want to put it. I'll come back on the next one.